these people are going to kill me. I just feel like they're even doing it tonight. You do not know what they have put me through. You do not know what they've put my dear loving father through, who never hurt anybody, so loving. I'm suffering every day because a group took an interest. But that group told me when they attacked me years ago and they were stealing from me that they killed Christians. They said that Christians were stepping stones, and they said they've been attacking me all these years because they couldn't understand why they couldn't make me die, why I wouldn't commit suicide, why I didn't totally self-destruct, and what saved me. They said they have tried so many times to run me down in my car and kill me in so many ways, but now I feel like they're actually doing it. I really do. The burning hurts to breathe. The head pressure, the static sound in my home, and it's one group, this one group, and I'm just feeling so sick tonight, I'm really ill, and they're blinding me too, and they tell me they want to destroy my face, they want to destroy everything there is about me. I cannot understand how the world can be so wicked that they have let them dissect me, test me, invade my mind and body and home, and kill me for all these years through torture. And no one in any law enforcement agency would help, except for my agent I hired, Thomas Martin, who has gone beyond the call of duty, who has been a saint through this whole thing, who has shown me that good guys really exist. He has been the only professional that I have met that comes to my beck and call. I mean, like an angel from heaven. If I call him and he's in a meeting, like yesterday, and I was in a crisis, he left his meeting. He called me in less than 15 minutes. With him, I mean, I don't care if I call day or night, rain or shine, and I leave a message with his secretary or someone, my phone will ring instantly. That is how professional he is. But he treats all of his clients this way. It's not just me. It's all of his clients. And he is so highly intelligent. But, you know, he was thinking of being a priest when he was younger, and now I can see why. I've been outside and my hair is all blowing. They were killing me in my house, and I was just burning alive and sick, and I had to go outside because I felt like if I didn't, I was going to die. I was just that sick. But I know Tom is a Christian, and it's such a difference. It's so refreshing to know that there's still people working on behalf of humanity that have all their marbles, that are highly skilled, and don't let the predators beat them down. I mean, this guy, as soon as he came to my town, he knew what was going on. I mean, he's such a super sleuth. He's better than the detectives you see in TV. He can come to the scene of a crime that every other detective will miss, and he will know right away what's going on. He's that good. But I know since the last election, these attacks have always been deforming in ways I can't recover. These people have been more ruthless and deathly since the last election. Since they told me to leave my home or people would die, their attacks have been to do permanent harm. And they've got me so sick, and that's the idea. They're like hunters. They injure their prey. They stalk them and try to drive them insane, and then make them so weak they can't survive. And that's what they're doing to me. But it's sick because of knowing where I came from and knowing that they take advantage of people that aren't skilled. They take advantage of people who have no understanding of fame, are monsters at all. But I told those people to get lost. As soon as I realized they were still in my work over 15 years ago, I told them to get lost. And all they did was gang me all this time. I don't know. It's through the grace of God I'm here. But I'm just trying to tell them again, leave me alone. You know, you're top people. You're well connected. You should have never picked me, ever, ever. I know who I am. And I know fame sucks. And I know that when I went to a conference, I said, I don't want to be famous. I just want to see if you can help me get published. I never wanted ever to be famous. I knew director Jerry Weiss. He was a friend of mine. I met him when I was in Los Angeles after I did a health club promotion. I was there for a short time, and I went to Dimples, and the owner of Dimples said, well, he's a famous director, and he's going to like you, and I was there with a singer because I had been robbed on the boulevard, and they stole my ticket and $1,000 that I had saved, you know, to stay out there for a while, and the lady at an agency I went to said, well, I want to introduce you to this singer to cheer you up. He'll make you feel good because you had such bad luck, and then they hooked me up with this director. They set him at my table. And then later I met other Hollywood people, and his house on Halifax was right close to Morgan Fairchild's. But I was never interested in that kind of business, acting. I didn't want to act, and I wanted to write. So then I went to the New York Film Academy to understand acting so that I could know when I wrote how to make my characters perform. I wanted to know all about what it entailed if I wanted to do cinematography or something to bring my creations to reality. These six SOBs stole everything I did, everything. But stealing is one thing, but killing me is another. They're killing me because I know my heart and mind and soul, and I know what I'm capable of, which these bozos don't. I know what I can do. But what I can do requires, it's solo. It is not with a group. I'm too shy. I mean, I'll talk. But when it comes to unveiling my soul, I'm too shy. You can put all the cameras you want here. You can sell all these pictures you took of me I didn't know about. You can do it. But my soul is crushed and tarnished, and I'm in deep despair. Feel such shame and such, just like, I'm half here because of such a violation. But you know what? You know, you stole my modesty. It's completely gone. I will never like your world. I will never perform in your world. I think you're a bunch of beasts and assholes, and I don't ever want to be in your circle. But a lot of idealistic people might, because you try to make it look like magic to be in Hollywood. I only know the pain you inflicted on me. And I know all the years that you got money off my suffering. And I know all the time you put me in Disney Animation, it was like some kind of offering. And I would imagine when you sprinkle people's ashes around the theme park, real bodies, it's some kind of ritual. But I don't ever go into witchcraft. I don't let my mind go into darkness. I don't want to know how to cast spells. People were sending me something tonight on how to break spells, but I really don't want to go into witchcraft. I don't even do church rituals. I'm such a happy-go-lucky person. If you leave me alone, magic comes through my love of God, from my soul. And it's just, people here tarnish everything that's good. I don't understand evil. I don't want to know. I don't want to know about darkness. Don't even send me this shit on how you think a demon's got a shape. A demon doesn't have shit. There is no demons in my mind. I don't see anything but light, harmony. No matter how much you torture me, I'll cry my eyes out. But you know, I suffered my whole damn life. You people come along, you try to get me telling you about myself. I wouldn't. You don't know the car accidents I was in. You don't know the times I was attacked. You don't know anything about me. I went through more shit and accidents before I was probably 12. Even a broken back when someone fell on me. You will never know. I was born crying my eyes out, a preemie with colic, and with other problems, had to go on medication, nerve medicine when I was an infant because I'd had such a traumatic delivery. It cut my eye and then I had to be put in an incubator for a long time. And then I was just sick, having seizures, having to have, my mom had to put a spoon in my mouth all the time, and I had high fevers. That's how I came into the world, bawling my eyes out. And then a couple of days ago, when I thought you were killing me then, I just thought, I'll leave this world the same as I came in. But I've never lost sight of who I am. I know my character. I know my worth. I know my visions. I know my heart. And I know my inner strength. I don't belong in Hollywood. You're flakes. I don't belong with crazy people. I like serious people. I don't belong in a rat race because I don't want to be phony. I can act if I want to do my own work with my own camera. I can write a strong script, but I cannot be with fools. I'm sorry. I would never waste my time trying to be evil. I will never waste my time trying to hurt someone. And I would never waste my time believing you're all bullshit. I write fantasy. I don't live fantasy. You know, I can write any script I pick. I remember when I was little, I used to write. I'd write 10 things at one time because I had such an active mind. I couldn't stand to just do one story. So I'd do heart, love, songs, poems. I would just be writing several. And it was how my pastime every day. And I put everything I had into my stuff. And I don't understand now how you people can take pride knowing you have wealth and knowing you have studios and armies to attack me. It's because I guess I made you feel small. You said I was strong. You couldn't break me. You said that you wanted to make me see there wasn't a rosy world when you totally just disassemble me until there's nothing left. You said you'd devour me and show me the Antichrist, or you'd kill me. That's your sick jollies. But you can't say you're big when you're telling me come and be in your world, and I refuse. But yet you're stalking me, trying to make me. It sounds like God in me is what's big. It's the God in me that's big. Look in the mirror, which you won't do. You're heartless, and you love that you're heartless, and you love that you're evil, but you're trying to make me evil, and I've got too much intelligence, so now you're destroying my mind. Stop experimenting. I'm so sick. I want to stay in my home here, and there's still things I like to do, but as long as you're hurting me to try to stop me from doing everything, don't say that I loved you or you love me. I don't know you. You were just a stalker in my computer. You never even called me on the phone. As far as I know, I've met you in person. And if I have, I don't care to remember. You are a monster to pick on me. You are a monster to tell a bunch of lies to people in other places and send famous armies after me. If anybody had a brain, a man, he would come to my face and tell me what his problem is with me. He wouldn't be like a petty girl and go get all her little friends to come and attack me. That is so lame. Not a grown man, especially a man if he's over like 6 foot freaking tall, that could just whip me with his little pinky. This is so juvenile. You might say your behaviors, this is how evil people behave. Well, I don't know where you grew up, but I know who I am. And you can be as depraved and crazy and as you want to be. You know, you can do drugs and everything, and you can do crime, but you're wasting your time killing me. I don't have any energy left. You said, oh, I'm going to give somebody else stories, and you don't want me to go to competition, and you never, ever, ever treated me good. You never even called and said something on the phone. You know, this has been years that you've tortured me, and you know, I know there's a God, but I don't believe there's decent people in charge because there are so many people that watched you do this and didn't prevent you. But don't ever try to make me like Hollywood. You have totally shown me what the devil is the devil through you, and the evil through the people that work with you in the business. If I didn't want to actually be involved with Hollywood, but I wanted to work through someone like at a writer's conference to have them sell my stories to get me a book deal, that's because I didn't want to be in the limelight. I avoid the pressure cooker because I have to have my own inner peace. I have to have quiet for solitude. And that's when I go into that writer's realm. And when I'm in the writer's realm, before you came, my God, everything was so serious. It was almost like reality. And I would redo a story 100 times or more. And I was into studying the dictionary. And I made an A at grammar at UCLA. But you said, now you've destroyed my mind. You laugh about it. You make fun of me. What kind of imbecile makes fun of me when they use these Nazi-type weapons on me? I see you as a bully, and I see you as evil, and I see you as weak, but you see yourself as powerful that you can destroy me so easily. And no matter what happens, all I know is I reached out to every source there was, and you would not stop stalking me, and nobody tried to help me, and nobody in law enforcement made you stop. Nobody even arrested you or investigated you. Nobody came to my house and stopped the torture. Nobody got rid of the weapons outside. They're on my land. Nobody prosecuted you for taking nude pictures with a hidden camera and sharing them with people. Nobody got you for hacking my phone for over 15 years. And nobody stopped you from hurting my father. But I'm telling you, I've had more than enough. There's nothing left to get from me. I have no interest in you. I have no passion. And I cannot create magic without interest or passion. And I don't believe anybody's who they say they are if they don't pick up the phone and talk to me, because you've been impersonating too many people. So stop trying to give me commands over the computer like a fool and having corporations call. Because you could be anybody. Please go away.